Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate a new capability in version 12, which allows you to view and edit a message assembly. I will send a message to a message flow using the flow exerciser and view details of a message assembly at different points in the message flow. I will save the message assembly and then alter it in different ways using the message assembly editor. After altering the message assembly, I will send it to the message flow. So in this message flow, I have a compete node, which is transforming an XML message into a JSON message. I can send a message to the message flow by selecting the send message button. So first I'm just starting the flow exerciser and I can click the send message button here. And I have a XML message here that I'm going to send to the flow. And you can see I've sent an XML message into the flow and it has transformed it into JSON and sent me a response back. So after sending the message, the flow editor changes from being in edit mode into record mode. And this is signified by having a blue border around the editor. And it shows text recording in the top left-hand corner. So I can also see the path that is taken by the message. It's highlighted in blue. And I can select any point in the flow on the blue line to see the message assembly. A message assembly is a logical representation of a message that's being handled by the message flow at a particular point. So if I click here, I can see the message assembly, and I can see it's made up of four trees. There's the environment, the local environment, exception list, and message tree. The message tree is made up of message headers and a message body. So in this example, there are two message assemblies, one before the compute node and one after the compute node. In the message assembly before the compute node, we saw that the message body was using the XML in the C domain here. And after the compute node, we can see that the message body is in the JSON domain. I can also see the message headers that are in the message tree. And I can see local environment details as well. So I can choose to save a particular message assembly. So if I select the message assembly before the compute node, I can choose to save it. So and I can specify the file name. So I'm going to call it Sanjay Demo. And I'm going to click save. And this saves it in the application that contains the message flow that is being recorded through the flow exerciser. So it's been saved, I've been informed it's been saved, and I can click close now. And now I can edit that message. In addition to saving individual messages, there is a new save all button. And in a later video, I'm going to show using that button to save all messages, and then using those messages to create unit tests. So I've saved the message into the application and I can open it in the message assembly editor by double clicking on it or selecting open with message assembly editor. So I can just double click on it and it opens in the message assembly editor. And in the editor I'm able to edit the name column, the type column, and the value column. So in this example, what I'm going to do is add an extra child element under name. So I'm going to call the new element last name, and I'm going to set a value for it as well. And now I'm going to save it. So that's now using first name and last name in the message assembly. And so I'm now going to update the eSQL in the compute node to expect that. So I'm going to comment out the code that's been used before and use this code here. So it's using first name and last name. So now what I can do is start recording. I'm going to redeploy because I have changed the SQL code. And now I'm going to choose to send a message to the throne. Now what I'm going to do is choose the sanjaydemo.mxml file. And here I can see a view of the message assembly that I'm about to send, and it shows the first name and last name elements. So I can click send, and I can now see the blue line view. And now if I select the message assembly before, I can see what was sent into the flow. So it has first name and last name and the XML and the C domain. And after the compute node, I can see under the JSON domain, it is now using a first name and last name and the response. So there's an example of using the message assembly editor to add an extra element and sending it into the flow. So the message assembly editor can also be used to add a local environment override. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to add a file output node. Wire it up. And add an extra HTTP reply. Wire it to the failure terminal to the in terminal of that reply node. And in the file output node, I'm going to specify /tmp/demo. Old in the node property here, and my file.json in the node property here. Now what I'm going to do is not use these values actually. I'm going to override add an local environment override in the message assembly, and we will see that the message flow uses the local environment override rather than the values on the file output node itself. So if I go back to the message assembly editor, and if I, on the local environment tree, I can select and add elements, and underneath destination, I can select file, then I can choose directory and name. If I click finish, I can see directory and name specified there. So in here, I'm going to specify /cmp/demo/new, and in here, for the name, I'm going to specify my demo.json and save that. So I have under /tmp a directory which is called demo_new, and it has no file in it at the moment. And so if I now send this message to the file, let's start recording it again, redeploy, because I've changed the file, and now send the message into the file. So this is using first name, last name again, and it has directory and name specified. So if I send this in, I can see that after the file output node, the written destination contains demo new and my demo.json. And in the demo new directory, I have a my demo.json, and if I cat that file, I can see the message that was transformed, the JSON message. Okay, so that showed being able to add a local environment override using the message assembly editor. Another useful feature that is in the editor is a way of being able to select an element and then right clicking and then selecting copy eSQL path. So I can copy that and it's copied to my clipboard. And then inside my eSQL, I can paste that path here. So here I'm setting another JSON object here under demo, it's called file name, and that will have the value of the name of the file that is in the local environment. So if I save that and return to here and record the flow, so redeploy again and put a message through, so the same message assembly as before, click send. I can now see that after the compute node, file name is now shown, okay? And that's taken the value from the local environment override. Finally, I want to show how you can see the exception list. So what I'm going to do is add a throw node. And that will cause the message to be thrown and caught by the HTTP input node and propagated down the catch terminal. So if I save that and send the message in again, so here the message has been thrown down the catch terminal. If I click on it and then open up the exception list, I can see the message that was sent back, so the problem's occurred, and I can see the message number as well. So in this video, I have introduced a new capability in App Connect Enterprise for the message assembly artifacts. So you can see it in the flow exerciser, and we have a new message assembly editor, which you can use to edit elements in the different trees in the message assembly. So the message assembly has four trees. It has an environment tree, local environment, exception list, and a message tree. Okay, so the message assembly can be used with a flow exerciser, or it can be used in a unit test. And I will demonstrate how to use a recorded message assembly in a unit test in a separate video.